Hello, my name is Robbie Graham and I play the euphonium. Jaime Teixidor was a composer, conductor, and publisher who lived most of his life in Barcaldo, a picturesque city in northern Spain. Though best known for Amparo de Roca, Teixidor was a prolific composer of music for bands. His compositions became so numerous, eventually totaling over 500, that he decided to start his own publishing company. Amparo de Roca is one of the band world's most popular pasodoble. The pasodoble is a typical Spanish march style musical style, as well as the corresponding dance style. Please enjoy Amparo de Roca.
The hymn tune is heard three times in the piece, once with light accompaniment, blends with traditional harmonization, and finally, in a rich and powerful statement of victory and joy. All vocal parts are optional and cued in wind instruments. This is Beyond My Vision, arranged by Travis Cross.
Thank you. soon. Symphony number 4 for Winds and Percussion was commissioned by and dedicated to the McCracken Middle School Symphonic Band, Skokie, Illinois. This premiere had a 2004 Illinois Music Educators Association All-State Conference on January 30, 2004, with the composer conducting. Written in 4 movements, Symphony No. 4 derives most of its motivic material from the first 2 measures. Several extended techniques and contemporary compositional methods are used throughout the work. These include bowed percussion, dissonance, aleatoric music, unmetered measures, singing, and extended use of the octantic scale. As is customary in multi-movement works, please hold all applause until the end of the last movement. Please know that movements 2 and 3 will be performed continuously. This is Symphony No. 4 by Andrew Bolson. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Rosemary and I play the clarinet. After the widespread success of his operetta El Capitan, Sousa regrettably declined an offer of $100,000 for a follow-up operetta, The Bride-Elect, from which this march was extracted. The operetta soon passed from the musical scene, but the march was a favorite of his bandsmen for many years to come. The Bride-Elect was pieced together from various sections of the operetta. The principal theme was developed from the song Unchain the Dogs of War, which ended Act Two. The march was sometimes programmed by the Sousa Band under that title. According to Frank Simon, cornetist of the Sousa Band from 1914 to 1920, the Bride-Elect was among Sousa's own favorites. He once referred to it as the best march he had ever written. This is John Philip Sousa's The Bride-Elect.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Ali, and I play alto sax. Armenian Dances Part 1 constitutes a four-movement suite for wind ensemble based on authentic Armenian folk songs from the collected works of Kamidas Var Tabej, the founder of Armenian classical music. Part 1 is an extended symphonic rhapsody built upon five different songs. It's hoped that the overall effect of the music will be found to remain true in spirit to the work of this brilliant composer slash musicologist, who almost single-handedly preserved and gave to the world this beautiful folk music. Part 1 of Armenian Dances was completed in the summer of 1972 and first performed by Dr. Harry Vejian, to whom the work is dedicated, and the University of Illinois Symphonic Band. Thank you for coming out to tonight's concert and supporting the New South Wales Rural Fire Service. Please enjoy Alfred Reed's Armenian Dances Part 1.
Before we get to the music, just a quick few things that we would like to note here. So first off, thank you all again for coming out and supporting the New South Wales Rural Fire Service. It's a fantastic organization. We greatly appreciate your support, not only for that organization, but also for the student musicians here tonight. So thank you. There are some recognitions that we would like to do at this time. So first off, we have, I believe, 28 students from Schaumburg High School who are participating in the District 211 Honor Band this weekend. So that's going to be at Palatine High School at 2 o'clock under the direction of Dr. Mike Fansler from Western Illinois University. We're really excited to have a lot of our students work with him coming up on Friday and then Saturday. So if you are a member of this year's D211 Honor Band, please stand up and be recognized. This past weekend, we had a number of students who participated in the Elk Grove Day of Percussion and IHSA Solo and Ensemble Festival over at Harvard High School. And students had a great experience getting a chance to get feedback from some clinicians who have not heard them before, and get a chance to see their own growth over the course of the last several months here. So we did have 66 events receive a Division I rating, which is the highest that you can get, so we congratulate those students. And then we also had six events that were selected as best of day, which means that among that room, the judge selected that event as the top performance. So I would like to recognize those. So for solos, Shane Andrus on tenor saxophone. Robbie Graham on euphonium. Joey Marzillo on bass clarinet. I'm not sure if he's here tonight. Yuma Okada on flute. Is he here tonight? And two ensembles were also selected. The Wind Symphony Oboe Trio. And the James Trombone Quartet. So many of those students will be performing on our chamber night, which is coming up next Tuesday, along with several other events that participated at Elk Grove Day of Percussion and at Harvard High School. So we hope that you'll join us next Tuesday for our evening of chamber winds and percussion, 7 o'clock right here. And then finally, in terms of recognitions, we did have two students from Schaumburg High School who were selected for the ILMEA All-State Ensembles. And we did want to recognize them on this outstanding achievement. This means that they were selected as basically the top musicians in the state of Illinois. So we have two students that we'd like to recognize. So first up, This student earned the fifth chair horn position in the honor band, which is a huge accomplishment, especially as a sophomore, and that's Mr. Reese Barlow. Also, in the trombone section, senior bass trombonist who was selected for the All-State Orchestra, Mr. B.J. Check. Thank you again, once again, for coming here. After tonight's concert, we are taking the ever-important yearbook photo. So if you can just stick around for a few more minutes, we'll get that taken care of, starting with the Wind Symphony and then Symphonic Band. And then finally, as many of you know, the band is planning to travel to California. And we just wanted to give kind of a quick update with that. In light of what has been happening in the world here, we have been in very close contact with District 211 and with Bob Rogers Travel. So we are finishing up some details and in contact with them. Expect an email from us with some updates. I would say probably within the next 24 hours on that. We will send you all that as soon as that is finalized. So we want to end here with the music, a wonderful work by Alfred Reed. So we hope you enjoy our remaining dances, and thank you once again.